to disassemble, repair, and assemble your Google Nexus 5, you will need a small Phillips and bladed screwdriver and a pair of tweezers. You'll also need a plastic separation tool. You can use a plastic knife, your thumbnail, guitar pick, or something similar. To help remove the battery, you'll need a thin, blunt instrument of some kind. And to help remove the rear cover, here I have a hot air heat gun. You could use a fan heater or possibly a hairdryer. Make sure your device is completely shut down. Remove the SIM tray. Use a thin plastic tool to separate the clips which I've marked in white. Starting at the top, carefully separate the rear cover from the housing, releasing the clips as you go around. If you can't use a thumbnail, you can use a guitar pick or a plastic spudger. It's harder to release the clips near the bottom as there's some adhesive holding the back in place. Keep working your way around the edge. And once you've released this clip, you can carefully lift the back away. To make it easier, we can soften the adhesive along the bottom using some hot air from a hairdryer or a heat gun. That will make the back lift away a little bit easier. This is the double-sided tape that's holding it in place. If you're replacing the rear cover, you'll need to exchange all the components over to your new one. You can remove the vibrating motor by twisting and lifting away. You can use some heat to soften the adhesive. And then using some fresh adhesive, you can place it into your new case. This is the GPS antenna connections, and you may have to remove and exchange this over to a new rear case. You can use some heat to soften the adhesive and a pair of tweezers to peel it away, being careful not to pull too hard or you'll tear the ribbon. Then place it into your new housing and make sure the small pin lines up with this hole. This is one of the multi-band 4G antennas. Make sure you exchange this over to your new case. And this is the Bluetooth and Wi-Fi antenna, which will need exchanging over to your new case. And if your new rear cover doesn't come with this RF shielding, you can warm this up and carefully peel it away. And put that onto your new case. These two contacts are for the NFC antenna, and these two are for the wireless charging circuit. It's best to remove this charging pad in two stages. Using some heat to soften the adhesive, carefully lift the metallic pad away. Using some heat to soften the adhesive, slowly and carefully peel away the NFC and charging circuit. Try not to bend the copper tracks too much. If you purchase an OEM rear cover, it will come with this circuit and all the antennas and the vibrating motor already attached. These small metal discs can also be removed and exchanged over to your new case. When placing this circuit into your new cover, make sure it lines up with the markings and it sits perfectly central. This is the inductive wireless charging circuit, and these are for the NFC antenna. The four small silver discs and this metallic pad will help the phone stick to a magnetic wireless charging station. If you need to remove or replace the battery, undo these six silver screws. These are all the same size, so don't worry about getting them mixed up. This is held in place with some adhesive under here. Lever and lift this away. If you need to replace the camera lens, you can replace this whole cover or push the old lens out and then glue your new one back in. Now we can disconnect the battery. Be sure to use something plastic to avoid shorting the battery. Now unplug the main flex cable. This provides connection for the display, loudspeaker, microphone and notification LED. Be very careful and gently lift that away. Now lever the battery out of the case using something strong and thin. You can use some heat to help soften the adhesive. Take your time and it will gradually come unstuck. This is the only adhesive holding it in place. To remove or replace the USB port, start by undoing these four screws. These are the same size as the other screws, so don't worry about getting them mixed up. this lifts away quite easy. This is one of the multi-band 4G antennas. This is the 3G GSM antenna. This is the loudspeaker, and these are the contacts. Disconnect the display flex. Now carefully and gently unplug the 4G antenna cable. And push that aside. Disconnect the 3G GSM antenna cable. Gently lift the board up. There's a small amount of double-sided adhesive holding this in place. Using your screwdriver, gently twist and lift this away. These contacts are for the 4G antenna, and these two are for the loudspeaker. This is the main voice microphone and notification LED. You may need to remove this plastic spacer if you have a new flex. Lift the notification LED away. Using a thin blade, you can separate the plastic spacer from the board. A new USB board will be flat. You'll need to put a slight bend in the cable where the white lines are and replace that plastic spacer. Then place the notification LED back onto that small locating pin. And you can reassemble from this stage. To remove the main board, disconnect the main camera flex. You cannot remove the camera yet, as it has a board running underneath. Disconnect the forward-facing camera. Unplug the 3G and GSM antenna cable and the 4G antenna cable. Gently lift the main board up and away. This connector is for the NFC and wireless charging board. These two contacts are for the wireless charging circuit, and these two are for the NFC. This metal shield can be lifted off to reveal the components underneath. If you're replacing the wireless charging and NFC board, separate it from the shield. And fit your replacement. This is the electronic compass, 6-axis gyro and accelerometer, multiband LTE transceiver, RF amplifier, your mass memory, power management chip, and underneath this silver cover is the 4G Wi-Fi combo chip. This large chip is the DDR RAM and the CPU is underneath. This metal shield can also be lifted if you're recovering from water damage. It's a good idea to lift this off and make sure it's nice and clean and dry underneath. This is the quad band GSM power amplifier, envelope tracking, battery charge regulator, CPU and RAM, audio codec, slim port transmitter, and another power management chip. This is the secondary microphone used for background noise suppression and stereo recording, infrared LED and ambient light sensor, which doubles as the proximity sensor. Power switch. The Simtray can only be replaced by heating up all of these solder contacts at the same time using a hot air soldering iron. If you are replacing this metal shield, make sure you line up the small clips around the outside edge, and you can see the shield pushing all the way down so it's flush with the mainboard. The same with this one. Make sure the clips line up. Keep moving it around until you feel it clip down into place. These gold contacts are for the vibrating motor, LED flash. This contact is for the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And these two are for the multi-band antenna. And this is a test port for that antenna. These contacts are for the GPS antenna. And again, it has an external test port. Reconnect the NFC and wireless charging. This small rechargeable cell keeps the time and date while you're replacing the main battery. And this external test port is for the 3G and GSM antenna. The main camera is held in place with double-sided tape. Don't pull on the cable too hard. Instead, use a screwdriver to lift the camera from the casing. This is a dual-axis gyroscope which controls the optical image stabilizer. To remove the headphone socket, insert a screwdriver and lift it away from the double-sided tape. If you have a broken jack plug, it's easier to push it out as the end is open. To remove the earpiece, using your screwdriver, lift from this side and you can transfer that over to your new screen. To remove the forward facing camera, lift this rubber spacer away from the double sided tape. And carefully lever the camera away from the glass. This double-sided tape helps prevent dust getting between the camera lens and the glass screen. If your new screen doesn't come with this rubber microphone gasket, you can remove it, then place it into your new screen frame. If necessary, you can remove and exchange the power button over to your new screen frame. You might need to exchange this double-sided tape for the camera over to your new screen. This foam gasket prevents dust from getting between the proximity sensor and the glass screen. The volume switch can be removed by lifting that small plastic tag in the center. And when you put it back, make sure that plastic tag goes towards the front. If you are replacing the screen and frame together, make sure you remove both of these antenna cables. This rubber gasket for the main voice microphone can also be exchanged over to your new screen. There's also a dust net which can be moved over to your new screen if it doesn't have one. If you have a new display that doesn't come with the metal front housing, you need to use heat to separate the display from the frame. You can follow this link in the top corner, see how this is done. For reassembly, place the forward facing camera back into the front housing. Then replace the rubber spacer. Give a gentle push to make sure it's stuck down. Now replace the headphone socket. Make sure you have it this way round. And the gold contacts are towards the camera. Now we can replace the earpiece. Now replace the main rear-facing camera. Now we can replace the mainboard. Make sure the flex cable for the camera comes through Check the volume switches are working. And the power switch. Making sure the board is pushed all the way down. Reconnect the main camera. Now reconnect the front-facing camera. Now we can replace the USB flex. As you push it in place, make sure the screw holes line up and that it sits all the way down. Now reconnect the main screen flex. Leave this unplugged for now. This antenna cable has a small and large plug, so you can't get it around the wrong way. Line this up and you should feel it snap into place. Before you push it down, reconnect the other end. This can be a little bit tricky. Then push the rest of the cable into its groove. This cable also has a small and large plug, starting with the smaller one. Carefully line it up. And before you push it down into the frame, plug this one in. Keep moving it around. Eventually, it'll snap into place. Now push the flex into its groove. Now replace the battery. Put in the battery up as far as it will go, leaving a small gap at the bottom. This makes it easier to remove later on. Don't connect the battery just yet. Now we can plug in the USB and display flex. A final check to make sure everything's connected and pushed down in place. Now reconnect the battery. Replace the loudspeaker antenna assembly. Replace the main board cover, making sure the camera lens is clean on the inside. And finally, the rear housing. Put in the bottom one first. And keep squeezing those clips back together. Insert your Simtray. And we now have a fully assembled Google Nexus 5. If you find your new screen isn't working, double check all the connections. And if you can, try plugging the old screen in and see if that works okay. If it does, it would suggest that you have a faulty new screen. Make sure everything's working okay. Make sure the front-facing camera is also working. And test to make sure the earpiece and the loudspeaker are working okay. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give me a thumbs up, and I shall make some more.